Hello, and today I'm going to show you how easy it is to get fit with the boxer skip with my 5-minute boxer skip jump rope workout. The reason why the boxer skip is so beneficial is because you're sharing the workload between both legs, you're able to skip for longer periods. What I'm going to do today in this boxer skip workout is I'm going to show you different boxer skip variations, which are going to help you improve your fitness, your balance, your coordination, and your footwork, and give you more confidence learning how to jump rope. By practicing for just 5 minutes and including these workouts as part of your training, whether that's as a warm up, at the end, or on rest days, is a great way of becoming more consistent with practicing and building jump rope into a routine. Today, I'm going to show you how easy it is in a short, quick, and effective 5-minute workout. All you're going to need is some space. Today, I'm going to be practicing at home in my garden, which is where I do the majority of my practicing. You're going to need a jump rope. I'm going to be using my Pure White Eddie Jumps PVC rope, which at the minute is my favorite jump rope. It's nice and light, which makes practicing different types of footwork really enjoyable. You're going to need a timer. I'm going to use my iPhone and a drink. And this is how it's going to work. We're going to do a total of 5 minutes of jumping rope, but we're going to split it up in working intervals. We're going to do 20 seconds of performing a boxer skip variation, followed by 10 seconds rest. The rest can be completely stood still, or we can incorporate side swings or double side swings to have an active rest from the footwork. I'm going to show you both of these in this short 5-minute workout. We're going to do 20 seconds of work in that working interval, followed by 10 seconds rest, and we're just going to repeat that cycle until we've completed 5 minutes. That's all you need. It's time to get started, so let's go. So I've got my timer, I've got my rope, and I've got my drink. It's time to get started. I put 5 minutes and 20 seconds on the clock, so it gives me 20 seconds to get into position. Timer started. Put my timer down, put my drink down, get my rope ready, and I'm ready to go. 10 seconds and we're in. Make sure every single interval we're ready to start sharp. We're gonna go straight in at footwork number one, which is the boxer skip. Let's go. So the boxer skip is where we're just hopping once on each leg, shifting that workload from one foot to the other. We're just gonna go nice and steady with this first round, and we're only doing 20 seconds of work. So little weight shift, hopping, sharing that workload, staying nice and light and bouncy. Quick form check, elbows back, wrists spinning the rope. And that is my first 20 second interval. I'm now doing double side swings where I can move the body, but I'm having an active rest. As soon as I've had 10 seconds rest, we're back in. Footwork number two, we're gonna do toe taps. This is where we're just touching the toe out ahead of us like this, nice and steady. Again, getting used to moving our feet in different directions, improving that footwork, that fitness, balance and coordination, and just building up our confidence, learning how to jump rope. We're only doing 20 seconds. Now another 10 seconds rest. Doing back to double side swings to have that active rest. 3 seconds, make sure you're ready to go. Here we go. Now we're gonna do heel taps. Touching the heel out just ahead of us, just a couple of inches, touching different parts of the feet, still sharing that workload, staying nice and steady. The goal is to get through the entire 5 minutes with making as little mistakes as possible. And that's 20 seconds, back to double side swings. Now we're gonna crank it up a bit. They're the three most basic boxer skip footwork variations. I'm now gonna show you a little one that's a bit more advanced, and we're doing the lateral boxer skip. This is where now we're touching the foot out towards the side like this. Laterally, again, getting used to moving the feet in different directions. Only 20 seconds, trying to get through the entire interval, making as little mistakes as possible. There's 20 seconds, 10 seconds rest. Now the final footwork, we're gonna do the double boxer skip. So now it's two hops on each foot, all right? Okay, ready? So double hop, it's a double bounce, so two hops, but we're just adding that little kiss with the opposite foot. So this is a progression from the standard boxer skip, because now we're doing the double, and these are all different boxer skip variations that I would practice on a rest day, where you get a nice active rest, still working your balance, your fitness, your coordination, a low level plyometric skill, so you're still increasing that power and staying switched on, or even on days where you're resting. That is one round. We're now gonna repeat that exactly the same, but this time you can crank up the speed and make it a little bit harder. So back to the boxer skip, you ready? Oh, ready? Okay, let's go. A little less talking now. little bit more focus. Sharing that workload, picking up the speed, followed by 10 seconds rest. And back to double side swings. If you can't do these, then just rest. You could just do normal side swings where you just hit one. I like to do double. Okay, now, ready? We're on toe taps. Again, just cranking up that speed, making it a little bit harder, cranking up the speed, the intensity. See if I can get through the workout without making as little mistakes as possible. 10 seconds to go. Head up, staying nice and light and bouncy. As you can see now, my heart rate's up. So practicing these short spells, when done correctly, it's just a fun, challenging way of improving that fitness. And like I said, building it into a routine where you can practice and become consistent. Okay, 3 seconds and I'm back in. Now we're on heel taps, ready? Ten seconds to go. Five, four, three, two, one. Two more intervals. You can move around while you're doing double side swings. You're constantly on the move for them 5 minutes. It's 5 minutes of work. Okay, we're back to the lateral boxer skip now. This one's a little bit more tricky. Ready? So we're going out to the side, but now I'm looking to speed it up. I can even move around a little bit. I'm just constantly moving the feet in different directions, challenging the body and my footwork and my fitness. Almost tripped. Multitasking, talking and skipping. Okay, here we go. 3 seconds left. Three, two. And now I'm on the final interval. I've got 10 seconds rest. I'm on a double boxer skip to finish. I'm gonna try and speed this one up. You don't have to go fast, you can just do it slow. Depends where you're at in your jump rope journey. Okay, ready? The main thing is that you're building up your confidence jumping rope. If you find yourself messing up all the time, then chances are you need to practice these footwork individually. But once you get a base of these, you can then make them a little bit harder by putting them in a workout. And I just find that a real fun way of improving your fitness as well as practicing jumping rope. And that, boom, is your 5 minute boxer skip workout. Good luck and let me know how you get on. If you've enjoyed this workout, once you've gone through it yourself, leave me a comment, let me know how you get on. And if you want to see more of this, then let me know in the comment section and I'll be happy to create more 5 minute jump rope workouts to help you not only improve your fitness, enjoy the experience of practicing how to jump rope, but also elevate your jump rope skills. Now let's go.